Good evening, folks. It's November 22nd, 2019, on a Friday. It's 6:18 p.m. This is the Word for Today, Part 2, for November 20th. Word for Today, Part 2, number 20th. Let's go right into the Word without further ado. So, November 20th, at 5:11 p.m., the Word of the Lord comes to me. And the Lord's saying to me, my sins were nailed to the cross with Christ. That's the message I got from God. That my sins were nailed to the cross with Christ. And that's the message He gave me. This was found in the book of Colossians, chapter 2, verses 14 and 15. Key verse 14. Colossians 2, 14 and 15. Having wiped out the handwriting of requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us, and He's taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross. Having disarmed principalities and powers, He made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it. Okay, next up, I'm hearing this song in my head. I don't know if it's Asperger's or what it is. I hear the song at 5:14 p.m. on November 20th. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know. That's a song. So I went to the YouTube channel called Kornfucious, and this is the link right here. You can type it out. I'm also going to post a link in the description box so you can find it. So this is the song. So I'm going to go ahead and post that on there for you. So at 5:15, swing low, sweet chariot, coming forth to carry me home. Yeah, I sung that on about quarter after 11 on my way back from disappointment. It's also found here in the YouTube channel, Listen and Read Along channel. I'll also post a link in the description box about this too, so it's also a song. And then at 5:16 p.m., I get this song. Go down, Moses, tell old Pharaoh to let my people go. That's a Negro spiritual song. So now we're talking about songs about people of slavery and oppression. So if you go to the Kristina YouTube channel, it's about slavery and oppression. You can look those up in the Wikipedia. I'll post the links to the Wikipedia articles on that. And here's the link to it, to that. I'll also post a link in the description box about that song, about Go Down Moses. I'll also post the Wikipedia articles about Harriet Tubman and the Underground Railroad. Okay, so at 5:18 p.m. later on, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. This is found in the book of Romans, chapter 5, verses 6 to 11, key verse number 8. Okay, folks, Romans chapter 5, verses 6 to 11. For when we were still without strength in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet perhaps for a good man someone would even dare to die. But God demonstrated His own love toward us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Much more than having now been justified by His blood, we shall be saved from wrath through Him. For if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of His Son, much more having been reconciled, we shall be saved by His life. And not only that, but we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received the reconciliation. Okay, next up is an entry from 5:20 p.m. on November 20th. Follow the drinking gourd. That's a Negro song. And I'll post a link here to the Sing an American Story. This is the link to it, if you can copy it down correct. I'll go ahead and post a link in the description box about that song, Follow the Drinking Gourd. Next up, at 5:22 p.m., I get this again. I've had this, the Lord talked to me again about a couple of years ago about the same thing. Why do you oppress my people so? Why? Why do you oppress my people so? Why? I remember back in 2012 when I stayed at the retirement home, the VFW retirement home, he said the same thing to me back then. And here it is 7 years ago later. This is found in the book of Isaiah chapter 3, verses 5 through 7, verse 12 and verse 15, key verse 15. Isaiah 3, 5 through 7. The people will be oppressed, everyone by another, and everyone by his neighbor. The child will be insolent toward the elder, and the base toward the honorable. When a man takes hold of his brother in the house of his father, saying, you have clothing, you be our ruler, let these ruins be under your power. But that day he will protest, saying, I cannot cure your ills, for in my house is neither food nor clothing. Do not make me a ruler of the people. Verse 12, as for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. O my people, those who lead you cause you to err and destroy the way of your paths. Verse 15, what do you mean by crushing my people and grinding the faces of the poor, says the Lord God of hosts. Okay, next entry at 5:23 p.m. on November 20th. I get this that comes to my mind. The kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom of God is at hand. This is found in several different passages, three of them actually. Mark 1:15, Matthew 3, 2 through 4, and Matthew 4:17. Let's go to Mark chapter 1, verse 15. The book of Mark 1 and 15 is saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The book of Matthew chapter 3, verses 2 through 4. Matthew 3, 2 through 4, and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. For this is he who is spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Now John himself was clothed in camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey. The book of Matthew, chapter 4, verse 17. Matthew 4 and 17, from that time Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Okay, the final entry in my journal is at 5:24 p.m. on November 20th. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. This is found in the book of James, chapter 4, verses 7 through 10, key verses 7 and 8. James 4, 7 through 10. Therefore, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning, and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he will lift you up. Alrighty then, folks, that's part 2 for the Word for Today for November 20th, 2019, part 2. Stay tuned for part 3. They'll be up next after this video. Everyone have a great day. Take care of yourselves. God bless you all. God loves you, and so do I. Remember, Jesus is coming soon. Get ready. He's coming very soon. Sooner than you think. I love you all very much. Take care of yourselves. Have a great weekend. And I'll talk to you on the next video for part 3. Bye-bye for now.